Welcome to the Smoke Learning Channel. In the previous video, we looked at how Smoke can switch between different hard drives as its main media storage. Now we'll look at how Smoke moves media between projects and multiple media storage volumes. So here's the scenario. While on location, I was using the portable storage drive. I created a project associated with this media storage, and all my media was loaded onto this drive, and I started to work before returning to my studio. Now I'm sitting in the studio, and I've plugged my main storage back into the Mac, so now I have two visible storage drives in the Finder. I would like to copy everything from the portable drive to my main storage. Let's start off by launching into Smoke and beginning at the startup splash screen. The storage volume pop-up will show all the available attached media storage volumes. This consists of my main storage volume and the portable storage volume. I'll choose my main storage and press open. So now we are working directly with the main storage, and I'll choose to create a new project. I'll give this project a name, and I'll choose the settings relevant to the media that I am working with. I'll create the project and press start to open it. While Smoke initializes, just a note. Since all project settings files are created on the system disk and not on the media storage, you cannot create multiple projects on the same system with the same name. If the portable project was called TVC_shoot, you cannot create another project called TVC_shoot on the same workstation. This is because the TVC_shoot project settings already exists on the system disk. So, just to clarify, we are now working on the main storage volume, and we are in the TVC_edit project. To move media from one storage volume to another, you can switch to the MediaHub. At the top of the interface, you have the different browser types. The file browser is used for media importing and export. The media can be on the same local storage, another local storage volume, or even on another system if visible on the network. Switch the file browser to the project browser. The project browser is for managing media within projects. In this narrow window, you can see all the local projects on this workstation. Even if the footage is on one local storage volume or multiple local storage volumes, all the local projects are available here. Autodesk Network refers to all other systems visible to this Smoke workstation on the network. Because we are focusing on multiple attached storage volumes on this local machine, we are only looking at local projects. As a reminder, we are working in the TVC_edit project on the main storage. I'll browse to the TVC_shoot project and navigate through the folders to the footage and the edit. Remember that this entire project's media is on the portable drive. To move the edit or footage, you simply select the clips and drag and drop them into the media library. Smoke will present a pop-up window and ask you how to deal with the native footage. Unmanage media contained in selection. Cache media on wire? In layman's terms, Smoke has detected your original camera media in your selection. The media can be on any drive you have linked to. Any cached, optimized, or proxy media will automatically be copied. However, Smoke will never move your original footage, hence the two options. In the pop-up, Smoke is asking you to copy and optimize the footage to its current storage volume. In this case, it is your main local storage. Click Yes, and Smoke will copy the footage. You can now monitor this through the Jobs tab. The footage is now on your main local storage, and at any point you can disconnect your portable drive, but your edit and sources will still be available in the current project. Just for argument's sake, If you had pressed No in the pop-up window, Smoke would simply link to the material on the portable drive. This means that the drive would have to stay connected the entire time while Smoke connects to it for the media. I prefer to have local optimized media as this allows Smoke to work efficiently. This is just one example of how you can switch between storage drives on your local Smoke system. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Smoke Learning channel for future videos.